Something that I've seen a few people ask about recently is how to get a lighter dye colour. So often what people are saying is, you know, right, I've put a medium brown or a light brown on something, but, you know, the resultant thing isn't really light brown, it's gone too dark. Or I've tried to put saddle tan on something and it doesn't look saddle tan, it looks too dark. You know, often people are struggling to work out how to actually get those lighter colours. So there's a few different things that you can do to try and help you with that, which is what I'm going to talk about now. It's only going to be a quick video, it just might help some people out. So if you think about it, what your dye is basically a kind of a medium as such, so you know your oil dye or your spirit dye, whatever that base solution is, and then it's got pigment added to it. So you know your chocolate coloured dye is like your oily stuff with your chocolate pigment in, or with your brown pigment in, and it's that pigment that actually dyes the leather. So the first thing to think about is, if it's the pigment that dyes the leather, then basically you need a way of getting less of that pigment on there. So there's a couple of different ways you can do that. You can either thin your dye down, or you can change the way that you're actually applying the dye to the leather. So first of all, in terms of thinning, you can get dye reducer. So if you're using Phoebe's dyes, you can get Phoebe's dyes with dye reducer, which is what's in this jar here. It's not in the original pot because the pot was cracked when it came in the post, but that's what that is. It's Phoebe's dye reducer. Obviously this looks like water there, but it's actually like an alcohol type stuff. So what you can do is you can basically use that to thin your leather down in whatever proportions that you want. And what I would suggest you do, if you're wanting to do it regularly, is do some sort of experimenting and write down sort of your ratios, you know. So say you've got some chocolate dye, try 50% chocolate dye and 50% reducer, see what the colour's like, add a bit, take a bit away. When you get something that you're happy with, you can always make yourself up a big batch if you want, you know. So you could get a whole pot of dye reducer and a whole pot of chocolate dye, tip them into an empty jam jar, and then you know you've got a 50-50 mix, if that's something that's useful for you. So that's the first thing we'll do, is I'll just demonstrate that so you can see what the end result looks like. So we're just using this piece of scrap leather here. So what I'll do first is I'll take this professional chocolate oil dye, and we'll just dye a little bit of this leather the same as we would normally. So let's just take this piece here. Let's imagine we're dyeing this for a project. So that's my sort of 50-50 mix there. So that would be like, hopefully like a light chocolate. So just swirl that around slightly, let that mix together. So we'll take another fresh dauber so that you can see that we're not kind of affecting that result in any way. I'll try and dye this in just the same way. So come around this corner a bit, this next bit here. This will be sort of the light chocolate. So that's the dye and the dye, the reduced dye. Now the other thing you can use, you can change your application method. So the wool dauber is basically designed to soak up quite a lot of dye, because obviously it's wool and, you know, wool's very absorbent. So if you're wanting to dye a big area and get like a nice flat black colour or something like that, then the wool daubers are excellent, or if you're wanting any sort of a dark colour. But because they soak up quite a lot of dye, you know, sometimes you can have too much dye. Now, I don't know if you noticed, but when I put the wool dauber into the dye and lift it out, I always kind of squash it against the side of the pot as well, just to squeeze some excess out. Now, the other thing you can do is that you can change the way you're applying it. So rather than using a dauber, you can use something that's going to absorb less dye. So one thing you can do is what's called cloth dyeing. Cloth dyeing, exactly as it sounds like, is basically just using a cloth. Now you can take a cloth and stretch it over a block, so you've got a wooden block, that works to reduce it even more. Or you can just use it as you would if you were applying, you know, a bit of oil to something like a rag. So if I take this piece of cloth here and basically just tip the dye against it, so I've dampened the cloth down, there's a lot less dye on there than there will be on a dauber. And then we can basically just rub this around on the leather like this. So again, that's a different way of applying that, and you should find that when that dries, you've got a lighter colour there than you would have done over here where you use the dauber. So another option that you've got, if you're wanting to dye lighter colours such as light browns and saddle tans, rather than using the Phoebe's dyes, is to use these gels which Tandy do, the EcoFlow Antique Gel. Now Tandy market this as for going over tooling, so basically, you know, if you do some basket weave or something like that, or a border, you rub the gel on and the gel sort of goes down into the tooling, and then as you wipe it around, it kind of stays in the tooling a bit more and it darkens the tooling down. That's its main purpose. However, there's absolutely no reason why you can't use this just on flat leather. It doesn't need to be tooled at all. It still dyes leather. And what's good about this stuff is that you can build it up in layers. So you've got a lot of control over what colour you get, whereas with the dyes, once you start to put it on, it can darken down very quickly and you're kind of committed to that colour then. With these, you know, you can rub in sort of a couple of applications, see what it looks like. If you want it a bit darker, you can darken it or you can leave it as it is. And these come in a range of colours, so you can get medium browns, dark browns, light browns and so on. So what I'm going to do here is, this is for another project, but I'm actually going to do a saddle tan on this piece of leather using the antique gel, and you'll see what kind of colour this comes out to. So these antique gels you apply with a sponge. This is Tandy's own high density sponge thing, but you can just use a normal kitchen sponge if you like. You can wash these out and stuff, so I've got a couple of these, but you can use any sponge really. So you get plenty on, you don't need to be stingy with it. Basically, you just start to rub it in. What you'll find is when it first goes on, it can look a little bit swirly. You have to kind of keep working it just to get it in there and get the colour right. Now, because these are antique gels, they don't tend to dye in a very flat colour. You know, they can tend to look slightly uneven and slightly antique, and it is an antique gel, so that it's doing its job basically. But I quite like that anyway. I don't always like the lighter colours to look completely flat, because they can look very factory made. You know, they can look like it's just a huge sort of industrial sized piece of leather and so on. And I quite like the fact that it brings out some of the variations in the leather. It'll highlight some of the little scars and things, and actually just make it look you know, a little bit uneven. So once you've got that colour to about where you want it, what you can then do is come in with a different sponge. What you want to do is dampen that sponge down, and then if you want to even this out, you can actually give it a wet finish. So just take the wet sponge and rub that all over. What that will do is just take any of these darker sections out where the finish has clumped a little bit. And there you go, that's the resultant colour with that. So you can see that that's not completely flat, which is the antique gel, so it's not designed to be. But really, with your lighter colours, you don't need that anyway. And that's now going to dry fairly quickly, and it'll leave that nice golden saddle tan colour. So if you are struggling to get a lighter saddle tan with the dyes and you find it goes too brown, then do give that antique gel a go and see what you think. It's nice and easy to use, so, you know, see if you can get some good results with it. So another option that you've got for your leather is to get a little airbrush kit. Now, I did a video all about this little airbrush kit that I've got, so I won't go over it all again. But when you use the airbrush, obviously you can, with very fine control, adjust exactly how much dye you're putting on the leather, both by the kind of nozzle itself, as in how much you're spraying, and also the distance that you come back from the leather as well, can affect the colour. So these aren't horrifically expensive. I wouldn't buy one if you kind of, you know, you've got like one thing to do, but if you're running a little workshop like I do, I think this cost me about £60-65 for the compressor and all the airbrush stuff, and then you can just run your normal dyes through this. So, you know, if it's something that you want to experiment with, they're pretty good anyway, because they let you do other effects. You know, if you want to do your sunburst effects, or you want to do stenciling, or things like that, or use things as shields, you can do all that kind of a thing. But certainly if you want to dye a light colour, you could also use it for that if you wanted to.